right, ladies and gentlemen. You have waited all week.
Yeah, Boogie Page. Throwing it down for things BMX is ready. I know I am. Attack the ATB Airways. Let's kick it. All things BMX. It's a BMX show. Unlike the rest, if you need some info, they got the best. Like and subscribe. Kick back and relax. And it's all things BMX. It's a BMX show. Unlike the rest, if you need some info, they got the best. Like and subscribe. Kick back and relax. All things BMX are streaming to you. So post up on your couch, screencast to YouTube. It's gonna be fun. It will be a blast. You gotta do much, but kick back and relax. They coming to you live from a studio, or they might be at the track, man, you never know. So don't go anywhere when my rounds are done, cause the show's just starting, let's have some fun. I said it's all thanks BMX, it's BMX show. Unlike the rest, if you need some info, they got the best. So like and subscribe, kick back and relax. I said it's all thanks BMX, it's a BMX show. Unlike the rest, if you need some info, they got the best. So like and subscribe, kick back and relax. All things BMX got the boogeyman's back, so I wrote them this track to send some love back. JT, Melissa, Chris, and Paul, DJ Damon, kinda get it, entertain y'all. And I wonder who gon' have on the show as a guest. I bet some are good, who's gonna impress? Guess I will just have to wait and see. Let's get the show going and start the party. I said it's all thanks BMX, it's a BMX show. Unlike the rest, if you need some info, they got the best. Like and subscribe, get back with me. Said it's all thanks BMX, it's show. Unlike the rest, if you need some info, they got the best. Like, subscribe, kick back and relax.
Coming in. Welcome to the All Things BMX show. What is happening, people?
How are we doing tonight?
Oh, it's going to be a banger this evening, you guys.
We're going to have some fun tonight, huh?
Grab your seat. It's going to be a hot one. It is into season three we are. Still not canceled.
Kind of canceled.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit over there on Facebook, but we don't like them anyway, so it doesn't matter. We are on episode 123. We got Bombs Away. We've got the CEO of the Bombshell Racing System. Dave Burke was with us this evening. Our opening song is brought to you by the Boogeyman himself. Check him out on Spotify. Click the link in the chat. I got it in there on time this evening. Yep. And you guys don't forget, if you want to support the show, you can send us stars over on Facebook, and then they can tax the money and take it and whatever. We still get it, so it goes towards a new computer.
Yep. That's the goal, right? New computer.
Oh, Jesus yes. Christ, yes. Show's chat is sponsored by BMX Rocks Photography. Get on over to their website. Check them out, man. If you've got a picture of yourself and you want to put it on something, they can make it happen. They've also been to a bunch of the Nationals, so they got some really good pics from the National. So check them out. Get over there. And the they sponsor the questions in the chat this evening. So if you got a question for the guests this evening, put it in the chat. Melissa will bring it in. And we want to know where you guys raced this weekend. That is our question for the chat room this evening. Let us know where you guys raced and how you did. How you did.
First, second, whatever.
Didn't make the main. Whatever. We don't care.
I didn't.
You got motoed?
I got motoed.
By inches.
Yeah. That was one of the best races I've seen in a long time.
It was fun, man.
Yep.
Steve Kennedy.
They're banging elbows in the 51 and over.
Actually, that's what I race is 51 and over, but it was the 46 to 50 expert class is what it was.
Pretty impressive, man.
Yeah, it was fun.
Only missed it by one spot.
Yeah.
Our Newsmaker segment is brought to you by the BMX Racing Forum, the Reddit of BMX. Make sure you guys get over there and check it out. Melissa's world-famous trivia segment is brought to you by Bombshell Racing System. A lot of bombshell this evening, I feel.
Yeah.
Yep. Going to be a good time.
Bombs.
Paul's still MIA. I think he's starting the BMX League over there at Richfield. So the Pulverizer here hopefully be back soon. I don't know. He just might go MIA and just run the track all year round, him and Dennis over there at Richfield Park. DJ Damon is brought to you by our friends at Truth BMX.
Can you handle
the truth, Damon? Can you handle the truth?
I like that green.
Looks good. Looks good.
Yeah.
Our anyway.
No, the heavy pedals.
Oh, shirt. Yeah. Okay.
Our birthday shout outs are brought to you by our good friends over at On Two Wheels BMX. If you guys are at a national they're at, go over there, say hi to Jeremy and crew working hard. Show's opening is brought to you by the good people at Gate 9 Custom Number Plate. If you need a jersey design, to make sure you call Billy directly and tell him that Chris sent you.
Yes.
And you want a jersey design.
He will hook you up.
There you go.
Hey, check out our live stream version of the show. It's sponsored by Mega Design Group. You can also check us out on all the social medias at All Things BMX Show. And the podcast version of our show is brought to you by Die Job Apparel.
Now,
check them out.
Before we bring our guest in, got a little something for you.
All right.
Got a little something for you.
What do we got?
Sent over by the CFO of Bombshell Racing System today.
Oh,
I hope you guys are ready.
This could be cool.
It's time.
There
about
is an
that.
Intro, Dave. Woo! What's happening, man? Welcome
what
to the show.
What is going on, guys? How you been?
Good.
Great.
Good.
Great. How's things going for you today, Dave?
Going good.
Awesome.
I just wanted to take a quick second, because I know this is when everyone's online right now. I want to wish my daughter a very happy birthday today. You know, 28 years ago, I was in Wenatchee wildfires up in Washington fighting fires when she was born with the Marine Corps. And I missed her birth, you know, but there's some pictures out there of me and her. She just got married this year in Hawaii. That's where we were a few months ago.
Nice.
Right. Just wanted to give her a very, very happy birthday.
Oh, happy birthday all of us here, too. Yeah, happy birthday.
Wonderful. Absolutely.
Chris, are you going to murder her name later?
Oh, I'm sure I will.
We'll just put Bombshell Dave's daughter.
There we go. Hey, that's safe. I'll do that one, right?
There you go. You can still slaughter it. It's all right. No one's going to.
Hollywood's ready.
Call her Little Bomb.
Is he?
Oh, yeah.
Is he in there?
He's already in there.
Yeah. I'll settle down, Hollywood.
He's ready.
He's waiting, man. It's Dave. Tell us what's happened since the last time you were on, man. It's been, it's been a minute.
When was it that I was on?
Well, we can't say because it may be part of the Bombshell Racing System trivia question.
Oh my God,
later.
Don't answer that question.
Maybe. Possibly. Or it could be when you were on with Alita. We don't know, but it's been a minute.
Yeah.
It's been a minute.
It has.
It's been over six
months. There's a lot of things coming out. So I got a new hub coming out where it's in the works.
Nice.
You know, constantly new things. We just launched a new promotion where you buy a complete Orca, and I know this is on one of your. It's probably
that's all right.
Spoiling it,
can hear
but
it
you get a free park bike delivered anywhere in the United States. It's all inclusive, price and you know whatnot. There's no dealer price on that because obviously, if I'm doing it, it's for the public, not the dealers. Yeah, that's coming out, or that is out. But there's a lot of new things. A lot of new things.
So, question on that, just because somebody's probably going to ask you this silly question. So if I buy an Orca and then I get a free park bike, can I send that free park bike to my brother in Florida?
I don't care. Well,
ship it to him, or do they got to ship to the same address?
Same address.
Okay.
Same address.
All right, that's cleared up, folks. Don't ask that question. They got to go to the same place.
Is your brother getting a new bike, Chris?
Not now.
Not anymore.
The way I've hooked up all the shipping, both of them have to go to the same spot.
I just figured somebody would ask that.
Oh, I think that's a good question.
Yeah, that's a fair question.
Yeah. So cleared that up right off the bat. Same address, ship them.
So, some of them, depending on the sizes that they buy, some of them will be one box. Some of them will be multiple boxes.
Okay.
Hell of a deal, no matter which way you look at it.
Man, those bikes are sweet. You guys, go on Dave's website and check out some of the bikes on there that are the pictures. They're so cool.
We got them in the slideshow, too. Yeah.
The park bike's actually really sweet. I like them.
That's actually my son's bike right there.
Yep.
Nice.
That was a couple years ago. That was quite a few years ago. Oh. I got a funny story to tell you guys. It was funny. obviously over spring or over the summer, my son was here at the shop quite a bit. Someone brought in this bike and I was back there fiddling with it and, you know, just making some fine tune adjustments to it. And David walked over to me and he goes, "Dad, that's my bike." I was like, "No, you never had gold cranks." We walked to the front of the shop and there was a picture and it was his bike.
Oh, really?
The owner of the bike, they didn't even know. And he's like, "Yeah, it was the black and gold bike that he had. And he never wanted to sell that thing. His favorite bike ever. Besides now the American flag one that we came out with afterwards. But yeah, it was pretty funny that he recognized that bike and it was all because of the wheels. We always do something special with his wheels and he recognized the wheels and it was his bike. So yeah.
That's pretty neat though.
Well, they had a special bond, him and that bike.
He does. He, yeah. Almost every bike that he's had, and he's had quite a few because we've been in this sport for a while. He had the number one, all black prototype bike. A few years ago, I bought it back and I have the frame back after we sold it to someone, they sold it to someone else, and then I bought it back. But he can recognize almost every single one of his bikes that's out there.
That's pretty cool, though.
Almost 6 years.
Nice.
Nice.
No.
What new products we got going on?
You know, the thing that we're working the hardest on right now is a total new computer system.
Oh, good times.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, August 1st was our deadline. Obviously, we've blown by us that. There's just a lot more into it than any of us really thought of. And, you know, putting it all together, making sure everything's perfect before we launch it is where we're at right now.
So is this an ordering system for the website or?
Yes, it's a whole new website. So it'll have all live tracking, live, you know, pretty much everything you want. Obviously I have my visions of the end game and we're not there yet. You'll be able to go on there and you'll see how many we have in stock. It's going to be live inventory.
That's nice.
Yeah. Something that we've missed and we really need to work on. And it's taken us a little longer. We've hit a few roadblocks here and there and a few issues. But that's where our concentration is right now.
It'll be worth the wait.
It will be. You know, there's new products coming. Like I said, there's hubs. We're experimenting with some tires right now. We found some from Sri Lanka that we're doing some testing and we're making some changes with the company over there. They were branded before we got a hold of them. And once we make our changes to them and figure it all out, we'll probably rebrand it.
Okay.
So that's the NASA tire that's out there. You guys probably have seen it, a few of them. All the new bikes are coming with them.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, there's little things here and there that we're working on. There's the park bikes.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's a 16 inch.
Now, if you need a big guy to test your tires, they case every jump. I got you.
You got me?
Yeah.
So right now I only have 1 3/8 or 1 1/8, 1 3/8 and 1 7/5.
1 7/5
I'm working with the company to get 1.5s and then we're starting cruisers, which we've already started the cruisers, but we're working on the cruisers right now. When we found this company, there they are. When we found this company, they weren't, they're not the industry standard right now. They're 60 threads per inch. I'm working on them right now to get them 120 threads per inch. They do have a 120 pound weight rating on them or PSI on them right now. And we've put that to the test. I know David had his at 130 the other day and we didn't blow it. So I was pretty impressed.
Ooh, nice.
Wow.
I wouldn't recommend that on a lot, especially on carbon rims, because you know, the carbon only takes so much of side pressure. We've had a few blow that way. not on BMX, more on the road bike side.
Okay. Okay.
My son's got some mountain bike on his dirt jumpers and stuff like that. So
yeah,
we put those to the test. But yeah, they're there. You know, I think before we talked about the carbon seats.
Yeah, yeah. I got those in the slideshow here.
We just came out with the cheaper version, the plastic ones, multiple colors, black, red, blue, purple, white. Yeah, there you go.
Ooh, nice.
I'm pretty excited about that. We have pivotal seats, you know, so as you can tell, we're getting close to that bike being 100% ours. Well, I don't have to go anywhere for anything. Once we finalize these tire deals, we have the seats. I'm working on number plates. You know, that's my ultimate goal, is to have a one-stop shop. You know, we got a new
full bombshell top to bottom.
Yes, top to bottom. You know, we got different colored cables, and our cables are unique. So there's difference between brake cables and shifter cables. Everyone knows the shifter cables are thinner, woven different. So we went and put a shifter cable with the right end to it. It's actually a lighter weight, you know, with multiple colors. They do, what I've found so far is in the carbon frames, when you run the cables through internal thing or internal frame routes,
mm-hmm.
because it's a thinner cable, you do get that little rattle. I do some modifications to my son's where he doesn't get that rattle. Okay. It's just because it's a thinner tubing, and we do it to standards. So, okay. But yeah, there's all kind. I mean, yeah, I wish I could tell you everything.
are you keeping the same colorways like on most of the bikes? Are you switching the colors up for 2023?
Yeah, I don't want to share all that right
all
now.
Right, we're, okay. No
problem. We're
no, we get it.
I do have two colors that I'm working on right now. That's they're going to be very limited edition.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, very limited edition. I think when I looked at it, I said, I'm doing 13 of each and take that with 9 sizes. You can tell how many of each size I'm going to have of these two mm-hmm. colors.
Okay.
For all those Patriot people out there, I will have a really, really nice looking Patriot bike. I think it's the one of the better ones that we've had all year or throughout the years. I also have a very sleek, and obviously everyone knows paint puts on weight. So I have one frame that's coming out that's going to be very little paint. And it's going to be the lightest frame out there, and it'll be a limited edition one too. Those are kind of what I'm pushing at. There's going to be a couple other ones. I'm excited for it, and they should be here November timeframe. October, November is our goals. And also we'll push that. This year we had 9 colors. I've scaled back because multiple different reasons. If you have 9 colors and 9 sizes, that's 81 frames for every one color per size. So it's, that's hard to do. You have very minimum stuff. So I scaled it back. You know, we got 2 colors minimum orders, and then we'll have 6 main ones, so we can have more of each color.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So I ran into some problems this year where I didn't have enough of certain colors that people wanted.
So I guess my Marlo color frame is out of question, huh?
You're
Marlo. It's like a burgundy, Chris.
Oh. Okay.
If you was the pimp that you are, you would know that.
okay, I don't know.
I'm not going to say.
It's not.
Because there's one color that it may be burgundy.
Dave's on. No comment.
Yep. So if you get your 79 El Dorado, you get your you would get you a Marlboro.
you
know that Marlboro color.
Dude, my dad had a deep red Cadillac Fleetwood at one
See?
Time.
See? You should know these colors, man. No, that's the pimp colors.
You're
sorry, Dave.
The new gear bag. Getting a lot of chatter since the video dropped on Facebook.
That thing is cool, man.
Yeah, it is.
There's a, I don't know if you noticed it in the video. The first ones came out, and I think you said something to me in Vegas.
Yeah.
About it.
Yeah.
So we redesigned it. They flipped the both colors, so it's still upside down.
Gotcha. All right. But I mean, these things are they're awesome looking.
They are sharp.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're, you know, we did a lot to it. There's so much. I mean, my son went back and forth between his mom's house and my house a lot, and we lost a lot of stuff. And this bag fits everything. And there's different compartments for your dirty clothes and clean clothes and your helmet, and everything fits in the bag. There's a spot for your shoes, mm-hmm. your gloves, your keys. You can use it as a duffel bag. You can use it as a shoulder bag, and you can use it as a backpack. And my son's figured out a way to even.
Well, I got the commercial. I'm pulling the commercial. I'm sorry. I didn't know I had the sound.
You scared the shit out of me.
Man. I was like, wow, that was really
hello.
What the fuck did I just do?
Damon thought that was him.
Sorry, Dave.
No, you're good. You're good.
No, that's cool. I do have a question. So you have all these different pockets that things go in.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to sound really silly, but like I have a backpack or a briefcase, and it's got all these little pockets, and half the time I look at it and I go, what did they intend to go in that pocket? Why is it there? What's it for? So it'd be really cool to see what all these little, what's intended to go in the little pockets and stuff.
You know, I mean, there is, it's kind of, you know, if you really look at it, there's two end pockets that, you know, as you can see there, the end pockets is more for like your shoes where she's just pulling it out, putting your dirty shoes in. The other one is we use it for dirty clothes. You know, okay. You take out one jersey and you throw it in. The side pocket is where, you know, if you go on the one side is where we put all the gloves.
See, that's
you know,
cool.
The center pocket is where my son puts all of his clean clothes. A lot of people put their helmets in there. My son has a very special helmet bag that he uses, so his helmet never goes in there.
Okay.
As you can see, Alita, she's got a side spot for her notebook, you know, that she writes times down on it, and a place for all that. And then there's a little pocket that she puts her keys or pens and little things in it for it.
Okay, like your wallet and that type of stuff.
Yeah, so you know, we kind of put it all together and made kind of a universal for it. And David puts, you know, when we flew a couple times, the shoulder straps, there's a pocket there that you disconnect and the shoulder straps stick into if you don't want to use it as a backpack. And he sticks his computer in there or his iPad back there, which I told him, you know, make sure you don't just slam that bag down or throw it down because that's
right.
The bottom.
That could be a problem.
Is that where Alita had her sprint stand? Is that like, could you put a laptop there?
Yes.
Nice.
Yes. You can put it in there too. David likes to put it in the shoulder straps. I don't know. I think he wants a new computer.
That's a teenager.
All right. Send stars to David because he needs a computer too.
Right.
Yes. You know, he started his freshman year of high school this year, a couple days ago.
Congrats.
Oh, he has to show up with a new computer then. He needs a new laptop.
Yeah.
I can honestly say I saw the little, what is it? The commercial, is it TikTok?
Yeah.
Is that what it was? Mm-hmm. With Alita on there. And I'm like, that bag is really cool. And
You want me to send you this?
I got to get one.
You want me
those.
To send you the link, Chris?
Send me the link, dude. I got to go check that
I know
out.
A guy, man. I'll get that link.
You know a guy.
I'll get that one. Link sent right to you.
Okay.
Yeah. So, we started with the blue one that was factory only. And then we came out with this black and red one for, I guess Mike Santa Maria said it's a fire one, which it is. You know, so it's a good thing for us. Something that we're missing. I've changing up different things. I have some plans in the works for to make a clothing line, Alita specific. I haven't even talked to her about that, so if she's listening, she needs to come up with a logo.
There you go.
She's getting her own signature clothing line? Aw, shit.
Nice.
I'm going to work on that.
Nice.
Her signature clothing line.
But you need to make them in big dude sizes, not her size.
Chris?
Yes.
It's going to be interesting seeing you wearing Alita's clothing line.
Hey, she's a Michigan girl. I was a support man.
I understand, Chris.
Right. We'll use a bandana, right?
Yeah.
Your t-shirt for a bandana.
Right.
I want to see you squeeze into her leggings.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No one wants to see that.
Nobody wants to see that, right?
Let's tell you what. We'll jump over because the chat's going on. Right. So we'll slide over to Melissa, and we'll do our first chat check-in brought to you by BMX Rocks. Melissa, you ready?
I can be.
All right.
Please.
Yeah. He likes to spring it on me anyways. It's good. We're going to say hi to Brian Fell over on YouTube. Says, have a great show. Rick Carter, Beer Budget BMX. Says, what up, peanut butter necks? Emily Schaefer says, hello, fam. Thank you for answering the question, Damon. Damon says, hello, fam. Midland BMX is where he raced on Sunday.
Well, you asked.
Emily said that she didn't race, but they had a ladies' night in Waukegan on Saturday and a ripped clinic in Farmer City on Sunday with her new baby. I don't think she's named it yet, but...
Oh yeah, she's got the new bike.
Skewed. Yeah. Our friend Mike Miranda Hollywood with Dirty Knobs Podcast is over on YouTube. He says he's looking forward to those birthday shout outs, Chris.
Hollywood.
He also mentioned kind of on a sadder note, but we're sending out our condolences here to the family of Eric Brager. Unfortunately, he is a BMX brother and a CW teammate that passed away this week. So we're keeping all of them in our thoughts. Billy over at Gate 9 Plates is also hanging out in our chat on Facebook. Len Novak coming in hot from Las Vegas says, hi, everyone. What up, Dave? Look at that. Nick Dawson's also in the chat checking in. Loved our intro. Mike Miller says, Big Dave, nicest guy around. He just doesn't come to you. Is it Yucaipa?
Yucaipa.
Yucaipa. Okay, BMX enough. LOL. Just kidding, Dave. Organized Chaos loves the new bags. They said they're sweet. Martin Aguilar, Kenzie loves her purple seat. Robert Cardoza's checking in over on Facebook. Says that was weird. No notification on YouTube. I don't know. Things are all messed up, Robert. He's wishing us a good show. Our buddy Sean Gifford with Die Job Apparels also checking in. What's up, crew, on Facebook?
Giffy.
Lots of love for the new Bombshell ad.
Good.
Let's see what else. Oh, Billy wants to know if there's a cooler for his Diet Dew in the new Bombshell bag. If not, you should probably add one. You get a lot more Ohio sales that way.
He needs a can koozie built into the...
Technically, the bag can hold 45 liters.
Fair. Yeah.
So
he just needs a plastic lining.
So technically...
It's
water resistant too. Oh. So maybe
he could just
mix it all in the bag and then away he goes.
He's like a little tapper off the side.
Martin Kennard checking in on Facebook says, hello, fam. Giphy is also echoing the keeping beer out of leggings and sports bras.
Thank you, Sean.
That's not going to be a problem.
Trust me. Check. Seth Spangs over on YouTube says, how have I missed this? Love this, first-time listener from Legion of Valor Racing.
Welcome.
Thank you very much for tuning in. And actually, Seth was, we'll talk about it a little bit later in the show too, but he was just featured in our Gal Pals, the Moms of BMX podcast show. But we'll talk a little bit more about that later. So, Seth, we appreciate you tuning in.
Yes.
Our good friend Dylan Reeder is also with us around Facebook. Dylan, thank you for the stars. We very much appreciate
Peanut
that.
Peanut butter jelly man.
Okay, now Billy just says he needs a straw then.
See? So look at that. Go. We all came together and made this solution.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Absolutely. If anybody's got any questions.
And he didn't say I said hi.
Oh, well, yes. Dave responded to everybody and says, love you guys. You're right. I did skip over that, sir. Anyways, if everybody's got a question for Dave or comments or anything, just let me know.
Thank you, Melissa, and thank you to BMX Rocks Photography for sponsoring our chat room. We appreciate that. You guys, again, got questions, get them in there. We'll get them on for you. We were talking about the awesome gear bag from Bombshell. So I just noticed this in the video. I don't know if they're new or not, but I'll probably be making my way on the website when the show is over. Chain tensioners that look like the little bombs, they've always been like that?
They have. They've been that way for a couple of years. We finally got a lot of them in stock, but we've had those for a couple of years.
Those are cool.
Those are cool. As soon as I figure out where they are on the website, I'll get a picture of them up. Nice. Any races you've been to lately? I know we missed you at Akron. You had a bunch of stuff going on.
I mean, there's, you know, it's been a weird season. I want to travel a lot more than I am. You know, everyone knows there's a lot of stuff going on in the world, you know, gas prices and hotel prices and airfare prices. I need to get the riders where they need to be, vice me. And they do a great job of supporting the systems, supporting the company. And so me and my boy have just kind of been local a lot. He's got some goals set for himself. Just so everyone knows, he's living with me full time now.
Yay.
All right.
So that's a good thing. You know, he loves his mother to death, but there's some stuff that happened and some things that we couldn't control. And she transferred, or she moved to Texas. She lives in Texas right now, and we're still here in California. So he's put his head down, set some goals. He's training very hard. That's where he's at now. He's actually at the track. Grand Prix BMX, Mike Redmond.
Getting in those gates, eh?
He's getting them gates, you know. He's at the gym twice a week now. Hopefully I can push him to three times a week. You know, he's on the bike. This weekend was crazy. I don't know if everyone's seen the Whole Shot Award challenge going out there to all the pros. San Diego BMX with Tyler Brown.
Yeah.
You know, we'll be at that. That's our state finals. So we'll be there that whole weekend. This weekend, he decided he wanted, he about killed me this weekend, but we did Friday night dinner, and then we had some stuff we had to come back to the office for, broken pedals and whatnot to get fixed, because Saturday he was back at the track at 8 a.m.
Oh, wow.
Then he decided to go, I can't remember, I think he went to the mall with some friends, and then wound up dinner and then bowling, and then Sunday morning we're at the pump track for 4 hours. He went to a birthday party and swam for like 3 hours, and then Lake Paris Grand Prix BMX and did that. And one of the girls that was with him, She had a little accident and crashed.
Oh.
Took some meat out of her elbows, possible broken arm, which is, or broken wrist that we have found that is not. It's just a contusion and swollen. So
that's good.
You know,
that's
happy about that. I'm very happy on that because it was on my watch.
That's the hardest thing is traveling with somebody else's kid sometimes is you pray they don't have an accident while they're with you.
Absolutely. And, you know, it was just a local race. And I had talked to this family and said, hey, our kids train, you know, 6 days a week. We were at the pump track because, you know, right here at Temecula, we have the pump track race coming up on the 28th. She's involved in that. My son's not going to do that. But big event here. And they were training for that. And I said, hey, Grand Prix BMX on a Sunday, it's Sunday fun day. The kids get to go out and do whatever they want. There is no training. I don't want moms and dads out there, at least with my son. Mm-hmm. It's his decision. If he just wants to work on jump lines or if he just wants to, you know, work on a rhythm section, it's his decision. There's no mandatory gates or mandatory first straights or any of that stuff. It's whatever the kids want to do. And both my son and this girl were out there and they were doing their thing. And I don't want to call it the pro set because I don't believe that it's a pro set, but it's the expert line that they choose. And my son was teaching her a different jump line and he crashed.
It happens.
Yeah. And, you know, I'm very grateful for that family. They were very understanding. As I was calling them as we're driving, they're like, oh, do you want me to cook you dinner and you can come over for dinner? I'm like, let's just get there first and then we can talk.
Just make sure
I was unloading the bikes and they were, my son walked her in because she was, her elbows are pretty well screwed up. I mean, they're, there's meat missing out of her one elbow. So my son walked her in and by the time I got the bikes unloaded and walked into the house, they're like, we're going to the hospital. And I said, I figured that.
<You know? laughs> Right.
Hey,
better safe than sorry.
It is. It is. And, that's, you know, I don't wish that on anyone. And I feel bad. And I continue to say sorry to the family because it was on my watch. I know, you know, accidents happen, you know, and I'm glad that it's not worse than what it was. But the end of the day, the kids had fun, and that's the main thing.
There you go.
That's right on, right on. So No, you always feel bad when you got somebody else's child with you and they get hurt. That's always rough. It's rough.
It is. It is. Yeah. There's my daughter. It's her birthday. She's standing next to my son, and that's my son, my new son-in-law.
Hey,
I just looked up and saw that one.
How do you say her first name? Is it Camaray?
Camaray. I've always called her Ray. I think a lot of her friends call her, or friends call her Cam.
Okay. Yeah.
So it's just Cam or Ray.
I like it. That's a pretty name.
Yeah. Yep. Well, good. Like I said, happy birthday from the show.
I can't wait for Chris to pronounce that.
What? What's her new last name?
What's that?
What's her new last name? Is it Mather?
It's Mather.
Okay.
Oh, you got that, Chris.
I think I got that part.
Man, I better check and make sure I'm right.
Well, this little Facebook stalker saw that it was Camaray Mather, but I figured that was probably her married name.
Yeah. You put me on the spot there, and I had to second guess myself, and I was like, I'm pretty sure. Funny story about that. We flew into Hawaii. She got married in Hawaii. Beautiful wedding. The car rental place that I had, there was a line, and I was stood in this line for like 2 hours, and there was a couple behind me and they were talking, and I heard them say something about something. I said, oh, well, flights were the cheapest part of this whole trip. And they kind of looked at me funny and gave me a dirty look. And I was like, whoa, okay, never mind. And so we're standing there and they're talking and talking. And of course, when you're in line, I mean, you try not to eavesdrop, but what else? I mean, you hear everyone talking, and you're like hearing everything. And they were talking about wedding gifts, and they were there for a part, you know, a wedding and this, that, and the other. And then all of a sudden she goes, yeah, I can't believe they're both anesthesiologist nurses. And I was like, whoa, whose wedding are you here for? And they're like, Jake and Cam's. And I'm like, Camaray? They're like, yeah, how do you know her? And I'm like, I'm her father. And they're like, oh, you didn't hear us talking. I was like, don't worry about it. You know, it's all right. I don't know anything. But yeah, it was a great wedding. I couldn't be more proud of her and her new husband. Amazing family. Amazing family. I can't take a whole lot of credit for it because, you know, she moved away. Her and her mom, we separated when she was very young, and I was still active duty military and forced to travel around the world. So I wasn't there for a lot, and I regret a lot of things, but, you know, deep down, she's still always in my heart, and I always prayed and thought about her quite often.
Hey, you can't change the past, but nope. All you can do is be there for
forward.
Yes, move forward and be there for now. So,
right. Yep.
Yep.
So,
yep. And make sure you get some Striders, Strider bikes ready for whenever she has kids.
Yeah. She doesn't know about that.
I don't see those on the website yet. I have a feeling those will be in development for the 2023 year.
there's some things in the works. I had
that's funny.
A meeting with someone about one of those Strider things.
See?
Wanted some help, and I don't know. I'm still contemplating a lot of that stuff. There is some, so Stasics is big, and I know that's probably a topic that I don't really want to get into, but
nope.
Oh, no, nope. I don't know.
That's love source. Them, that's love them things. Let me tell you how much they're amazing.
Okay. Just make sure you plug them in.
Just stick with your Strider bike that you got in development.
It's not me. I don't want to do it. But I have a company that wants to team up together. And
there you go. Mm-hmm. Let them handle it.
You know, they're not Stasics. They're a different brand. And my first comment was, how can we make it faster so we can beat the Stasics? How can we modify
it? Are there any other brands out there right now? Or are they just is it just the Stasics that are out there in those little powered bikes that the kids are racing?
There's some coming out.
Is there? Okay.
Yeah.
There's got to be competition coming from somebody.
It seems like it might be a growing market.
Yeah. Look, everyone knows from my previous views and all any new time listeners, you know, my background is motocross, GNCC racing. You know, I grew up in the Midwest near you guys. So I still have my ties with the big factories out here in California. You know, it's less than 10 miles away. We got KTM, Husky, Gas, you know, Kawasaki's not that far away. Yamaha's not that far away. They're all right here. So a couple of them have reached out to me. One of them is talking about Striders. It's on their sites. I don't want to really go into that too much, but I had some of them come over and sat in my office and really kind of discuss something, a possibility of the future.
There you go.
With some of that. So, you know, you may see a Orca at the Supercross and Watercross races very soon.
Oh, ooh. Snap.
That now, would be cool, huh?
Question here. All right. Mm-hmm. Are we going to have an Orca push bike though for the grandkids?
Well, so there is one out there. There's a young lady that's I don't want to go in too much detail what she has, but she has an adult Orca push bike.
Okay.
Didn't we
see,
one?
It at the track out here every once in a while?
Didn't we see one at Steel Wheels, Damon?
Yes, we did.
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't an Orca one, but we saw an adult one, which I instantly thought There needs to be an adult Strider league that involves beer drinking. Like, you could have relay races with it. I mean, you're only going, look, you got to run, and we don't run. So I'm thinking, like, relay a straight, and you got a shotgun of beer. That is some fun.
Oh, my gosh.
When we first started doing this, and I have what it takes to do it, where the bottom bracket screws in, you screw in, and it's like pegs. So you could actually
like
make
a foot peg, like a motorcycle
tag. A motorcycle foot peg, absolutely. Okay. And with doing so, then we could just have true pump races.
Oh shit.
You know, without
that would be cool.
Any chain rings or anything.
But okay. You know what else, though? You guys are talking about the adult.
I'm talking about shotgun and beer.
I know where you were going with it, but I'm going to go a little different.
You're not
going to
be on my team, by the way, Chris.
Yeah. Well, what about like special needs kids?
Good point.
With that type of a setup.
It's been,
and that's the one where we're working on this one with. It was, and like I said, I don't want to go into great details, but yeah, there's a push bike out here for a younger or a child. And you know, all we did is put a front hub on it and two front hubs and made it work. And
That's
she puts that out there quite often, and you see it at the local track. I think the family actually left BMX and they're not in BMX anymore, so I don't know whatever happened to that bike. But that was a couple of years ago we did that.
There's another avenue.
I get phone calls all the time about, actually one of my neighbors here, they do a restoration where they fires and floods, they go in and clean the houses or whatever whatnot. And one of the owners came over and he had this 1930s bike and he wanted to put an external headset in it, and I brought it in and did some work on it and put it together. I get a lot of those walk-ins.
Sure.
Of nice. Just weird stuff, and we make it work.
That's cool, though. Yeah. I mean, really, that's kind of neat. You can take old stuff.
That's what I enjoy, and honestly, I've said it this many of times. I miss the travel and the one-on-one with everyone at the track. I miss building all the bikes because that was my creativity. Where I could, just one-off things. And Alita did she got a phenomenal at it when she was out here, and expanded her profile of what her capabilities were. And it's a fun thing to do when someone gives you that free rein of saying, hey, these are what I want. Have fun. Go for it. And I do it with wheels quite often. I'll show you these. You guys will like these.
All right, Chris. You need building a new bike.
Sorry about leaving for a second.
Oh, you're fine.
No, you're fine.
You can see how we just play with the spokes and the nipples. And, this one has three different colored nipples in it and two different colors. It's got the white spokes with the oil slick spokes on it. And it's crossed where it's, in four and four. So, that a lot of stuff like that Alita did when it came to that. I did different things where, this side of the wheel was one color and this side was another color, or we split that half and half that way. Those are the creativities and those are the one-offs that I'd love to do. Because you get a bike and, obviously the Orcas, you only get 8 or 9 color choices, and then every bike starts to look the same, and I don't like that. I like to make sure every single one is a one-off and personal to the customer. That's our goal. That's what we love to do here at the Bombshell.
What colors would you pick if Chris told you to make a bike for him?
Well, for my first choice are, what are his favorite three colors?
Favorite three, blue,
clear isn't a color, Chris.
Clear. I like blue is obviously my favorite. I don't really have three. I see
Green and
What's
white.
What's your two favorite?
All right, how about the blue, yellow, and orange?
Gag.
Patterson colors.
Dude. That's a hard one.
I should have known that.
Fucking gag, dude.
So this year I would have put him on. Yeah. We had that blue orange bike. So it was blue. Orca was in orange. And then I probably would have put some silver cranks, silver chain ring, and probably blue and orange chain ring bolts in it. And then just played with, I would just sprinkle the, in the parts wise, the orange and done a lot of silver because the blue with that blue frame just clash kind of. Mm-hmm. So, and our orange, you know, orange is gold in anodizing a lot of times. Sometimes the gold turns orange. I hate anodizing. You know, you have 7071 and 6061. The different metals and the different materials, it comes out different colors.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so the anodizing process is different depending on the grade of aluminum you're using?
Yes.
Really?
You know, and so it changes colors, and that's what is so hard. And then even one batch, do they leave it in a little longer so it changes the color a little bit? It's very, very tedious. And that's what's so hard about, you know, everyone's like, oh, the golds don't match. Well, some of it's anodized here, some of it's anodized overseas. It's very hard to, you know, control that process.
I've heard somewhere that gold is the hardest one of the colors to get consistent. Is that
it
true?
It is. You know, the pink is hard. The green was hard. Gold is hard. Blue, all colors are hard if you don't know what material it's made out of going in. Or if I had this happen to me in the past 2 years where they changed, you know, everyone knows through COVID that, you know, people changed different materials and some went cheap, some went, you know, whatnot. And we didn't know what we were getting at sometimes. Mm-hmm. I hate to say that, but I found out later.
Aww.
You know, it goes to anodizing and it, you call it 6061 and it's 7071 or vice versa. And you get it back and it's totally off. Mm-hmm. And you're like, whoa, this is, and you can't strip it because then it's, once you strip it and re-anodize it again, then it's just a matte finish. So I know there's a lot of complaints out of our lovers right now, and it's, that's the one that I had issues with. You know, so it's, you have to go through the run and then, you know, the colors will come back and whatnot. So it's, anodizing is a very tricky thing.
Huh.
You know.
Oh, I learned something new today. How do you...
Good. I'm glad.
Chris, as much metals as you deal with, you don't know about anodizing and stuff like that?
We don't anodize anything.
Yeah, and all your stuff goes inside transmissions, right? Or something like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have one part that gets a tin plating done to it, but that's totally different from anodizing.
You should get a gold tooth.
What? Why?
Why not?
Because I don't want one.
You need to get it for the cruise, Chris.
No.
And get you a 78 Broham.
There you go. any changes on the teams? Add anybody?
So we did some changes. We came out with the nonprofit organization. Mike and Scott run that. So I'm hands off. When it comes to the factory teams and stuff like that, they have 100% control. It's a conflict of interest if I get involved in it, because I'm one of their biggest supporters.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some legal stuff that we had to, you know, kind of separate. So I've kind of backed off of that, which took a lot off my plate that I have on my plate already. And it was a big help. So next time I'm on, I'll have to get the QR code for that and throw that out. If anyone wants to donate money to the nonprofit, Bombshell, their youth organization. They're going out and they're helping, you know, they're doing clinics. That's one thing that we're working on is, you know, using the pro riders to help with the clinics, to help promote the company, to help promote them for the nonprofits and stuff like that. So a lot of stuff that you were talking about that I helped you guys with the Beginners League. I know Scott's doing a lot of that in South Carolina under the umbrella of the nonprofit organization, and doing a lot of that stuff for it. So, hey, do you guys know the story behind the cards that are up right now?
You told us in Vegas, and okay. I don't know if we told that to the listeners.
I'm not familiar with
Well, it's hard to remember because the last time you were on, you hung out with us until 5 in the morning our time. So it really blurred on what was on the show and what we talked about afterwards. So, yeah, absolutely.
Well, if you can,
if you can
leave that up for a second.
I can go full screen on it.
So that was kind of the start of me and BMX. That was the first team that I put together. DJB is David James Berquist. And if you don't know, my son has a heart condition. He's had 2 open heart surgeries and 4 heart surgeries. He's gone through 22 surgeries. He's had all of his intestines removed and remapped and taken out his appendix. And the story goes on and on and on. ASG, don't quote me on this. It's Atticus Gnault, I don't know his middle name, and Andrew Bryson, both out of here of San Diego. Those were the first 2 riders that I kind of sponsored personally. And BSR came in afterwards. There was other initials there before. And if anyone knows, Biker Sherlock, he was involved in this at the very beginning, but before I got it done, he was found dead on a beach in San Diego. Different stories on how that all happened, but he was a very, very into extreme sports. He was the inventor. I don't know. Don't quote me on this, but he did the downhill luge. He had many X Game gold medals for the stand up downhill luge. And then it went down to the laying down one. Don't quote me. I'm not big into that. But he also had the dredge wheels. He was the CEO of that.
Okay.
But that was where his son's initials were supposed to be. And then they kind of, we lost contact after some tragedies happened. And it was left blank for a little while. And we came up with BSR. You can kind of figure out what it stood for, BS Racing, for a minute. But we couldn't really say that out loud, so it came out to be Brother Sister Racing is what we started it with.
All right.
But my son has kind of taken on that logo for his personal, and you'll see it on a lot of bikes out there. There's a little sticker on the forks above the front tire, and that's the near and dear, the personal, and you see it on my shirts. I have them on my shirts, and that's, I know Mike puts out there every so often. He goes, if you know, you know. But that's the story behind the cards. There for a while, we're getting phone calls here at the shop. Hey, how do I get that sticker? You don't. I make them every so often, and I get them done. And Grands or Nationals, if I remember, especially now, I kind of lost track on some things. I'll walk around, and people that are true family, that means something between me and my son, you know, they'll get a sticker and we'll put it on their forks. And Anthony Picardo had it on his for a while. And he changed forks so often that I couldn't keep up with them, you know, but, you know, there's certain people that, you know, and I don't want anyone to be, well, I thought I meant more to you, Dave, than that. And I was like, there's times that I just don't have them.
Right.
You know, or I don't think about it because my life is, you know, crazy at times that I forget about it.
That makes it more special. So everybody doesn't have these. They're hard to come by. And if
they are,
get one,
they are.
You're a very lucky person.
Yeah, and it's just near and dear to my son mostly. He when he a couple of years ago he wanted to do a he wanted to create his own business for 3D printing, and we did keychains for a while, and I think you guys have some keychains around there somewhere.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, he was doing all that on his 3D printer, and he wanted to create this own his own business, and he wanted to use that as his logo. And I said, "That's yours, dude. Whatever you want to use it for, that's yours." So that's the story behind that. So if you know, you know.
Gotcha.
Well, it's all good.
Yeah. That's awesome. What do you have as far as goals for the rest of this year? And then what are you looking at for 2023?
Well, right now, I mean, I said that my son lives with me full time, which has not happened in 12 years. My driving to Chula Vista has cut down dramatically, and I'm so glad because that was a lot of driving. My son has a lot of goals and a lot of, you know, he's pushing that expert. We got 4 wins left to go expert. And he wants to win state. He wants to go to grands. His goal, which it's a high order, he wants to win rock and he wants to win the grands.
Okay.
And turn expert at the Grand Nationals. That's his goals. That's... You know, as far as the company goes, you know, which he's very involved with right now, living with me, the new computer system, online tracking, live inventory, that is, you know, that will happen one way or another by the end of the year. New product. I'm changing the Kotho clothing line to a new manufacturer, and it's a new material. I have a vision of the Alita Beeman line of clothing, which I need to talk to her, and I'm saying it out loud, and she might be a little bit mad at me because I haven't talked to her about it yet. But I want her to come up with her own logo, and her design of a jersey and a pant, for the Beeman line. Okay. I got some new gloves that will possibly hit here shortly. And it's a high-end glove, and they're going to be expensive, and I'm going to warn everyone now, it's true leather. I know a lot of the pro riders use golfing gloves, a special glove type of thing, and that's kind of where these are based off of, but the leather is very expensive. So we're going to work on that. Hopefully we'll have those done by Grands. You know, and there's some other stuff that I'm working on. I hope to have some mini hubs. During COVID, we kind of lost the mini hub. I have a prototype one right now that's super lightweight. It's the lightest hub out there right now. I can't see anyone on it. There's a new bike out there that has been prototyped. It was in Vegas. It's been a couple races. That's coming.
Is that the one? Was that July's Vegas or was it February?
It was at July's Vegas.
Is it okay?
It was. One of my local kids is testing it. That's all I'm going to say on that because I don't want
fair enough.
Other company.
No,
that's
all right.
Jumping on what my future looks like right now.
When you're ready to let it out. Send it over here. We'll talk about it.
We're going to jump to a quick commercial break, Dave, and we'll be right back. DJ Damon's going to slide us on out of here on the commercial break. You guys don't go anywhere.
Telefonunu get bak jak burada diktafonuna tak kağıt kalem bir de ilham alınacak tam gaz çapız havada düşmana buna çıkalım bakalım hadi bu bedolu kazanalım. We started in the Midwest. Now we're about to take it. All over the world, baby.
Sports World, the best value in the world on bikes, parts, and equipment.
All right, coming back from commercial, Damon. Thank you, my man.
All right.
I think it's time. What do you think? You think it's time?
Hey, I think so too. Hey, just real quick, social medias, check us out at All Things BMX Show.
You got some more?
No, I just wanted to thank Sean Gifford for the stars.
Thank you.
We appreciate that, buddy.
Thank you, sir.
So this, we didn't do the last time. We didn't do lightning round last time he was on.
I don't think so.
No, we had.
We've revamped it.
We've revamped
a couple
the
times.
It's got
lightning
an intro
round.
And everything.
Yes.
It has
oh,
a
and
sponsor.
I did two things too. Sorry, jumping in.
Go ahead.
Put the link for donating to the Bombshell nonprofit in the chat. I also put it on our Facebook page in case anybody's looking for that.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely, they have a direct PayPal link, so it really couldn't be much easier.
Very nice. All right, it's time for lightning round.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, it's got an intro song and everything now.
Look at that.
And again, no thinking.
Yeah, we fire through these.
First thing that pops in your head. That's what we're looking for.
All right. Lightning Round is brought to you by our good friends over at BrandedPopUps.com. The mission at BrandedPopUps.com is to provide fan brand support with an opportunity to purchase a branded pop-up canopy of their favorite company. You guys can check them out at BrandedPopUps.com. We'll put the link in the chat here in 1 second. And as Chris said, no thinking. We're going to throw some questions out for you. And Melissa's going to get us kicked off.
All right, Dave. All-time favorite movie?
Roadhouse.
Goddamn good movie.
Whoa.
All right, Chris.
Hey, Dave, what's your favorite television show?
I like reality TV. Probably like Gold Rush or Gold Digger, whatever that thing is.
Yeah.
I don't know. Nice. I don't watch a whole lot.
All right.
Favorite snack or junk food?
Ice cream.
There you go. That's my man.
Oh, man. You and Damon.
Can't go wrong with that.
There you go.
All right, Dave. Do you wear slides or Crocs at all?
No.
Okay. Moving on.
Yeah.
Would you?
We probably need to replace that.
Maybe at my house.
Okay.
You know, running around the house, maybe.
Let's say, imagine yourself in a pair of slides. Would you wear them with or without socks?
Without.
Thank you.
Yes.
My man.
That's right.
But I got to get a pedicure first.
All right.
Fair enough.
No right, shame this, in that game at all.
This is kind of a waste of a question, actually, with Dave anyways. So, Dave, do you work on your own bikes or do you take them to the shop?
Take them to the shop.
I knew it. Most mechanics don't work on their own car either.
You got
wait,
Chris.
I take it to my own shop.
Okay.
Nice.
Fair.
All right, what was the subject you hated the most in high school?
English.
Oh.
All right.
All right, favorite pizza topping?
Pepperoni.
All right.
All right, here's another one. I'm throwing this one in. Are you for pineapple on pizza or against pineapple?
I like pineapple on pizza.
Fair enough.
There you go.
All right. Two for two.
Yeah, but you have to have bacon and ham with it.
Chris, stop it with the caveats, all right?
You know, honestly, I'm not a big fan of Canadian bacon, so I like to put the pineapple with pepperoni.
Very nice.
Ooh.
I'm going to have to try that one.
It's
one
of my favorites.
I'll try that.
Yeah. I like that one. Yeah?
What do you want on your pizza, Justin?
Oh, okay. Whatever. I don't care. I don't. But yeah.
Artichoke hearts is good.
Where should I get it
too.
From? I don't
no,
care.
No, no, no. I disagree right. with next. You on that one. No artichoke hearts.
All right. Next week.
You don't like artichoke hearts? Okay.
I like them, but not on pizza.
Next week before the show, we're getting pepperoni pepperoni pizza.
With artichokes.
There you go.
No.
Artichoke.
All right.
I will throw it at Chris if he has artichokes on it.
No.
All right, Damon, you're up.
If you have not done BMX, what would you have done? I think we know this.
I'd be in motocross.
Yeah. I was going to say that. Yeah.
All right. You like stuff sweet or salty?
Salty, sweet.
Fair enough.
Okay.
I like that answer.
Would you choose pie or cake?
Pie.
Good, okay. Man.
What's your favorite guilty pleasure?
Chewing tobacco.
All right.
Okay.
Hey,
that counts.
What it is.
That does count.
That's
hey. Enough said. That's all right.
Instagram or Facebook?
That's a hard one because I'm old school Facebook, but now it's kind of leaning towards Instagram more.
Okay.
Yeah. All
right.
New world. Apple or Android?
Apple.
In your three phones, are they all Apple?
They are. All three of them are Apple.
Sweet.
All three of them.
Can you imagine having one that's the other? And
oh, no, that wouldn't even make any sense.
I used to carry that at work.
Did
I'd have an Android and an Apple. Yeah, when I was.
So
when
if
I
you wonder why sometimes I don't answer the phone, it's because
you can't tell which one's ringing.
Right.
And with those three phones, there's five phone numbers.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, my goodness.
I can believe it.
I'm already overwhelmed.
Oh, all right. So what talent do you wish you had?
I wish I could either play the guitar or the drums.
Mm, oh, good.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, me too.
I keep trying to push my son to play the guitar because I would love for him to get really good at playing the national anthem and the Marine Corps hymn and play both of those at the Nationals.
Oh,
we're nice.
There you
like
go.
All right, here's
as you
one.
Can see, you know,
yeah.
Marine Corps. Yeah. We know you.
And there's if you look, there's the campaign cover when I was a drill instructor.
Oh, yeah.
And if you want to know more about that, watch the previous episode that Dave was on because we talked about that.
Yes, we did.
You'd have to decide which one you're watching.
That's we're gonna know in the trivia. Flats.
Thank you for your service, by the way.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, anytime. I always. You know, I loved it. I spent a lot of time over in Iraq and whatnot, and I would not trade it for anything. I mean, obviously, lost some friends, lost some people. But I truly believe what we did was right.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
You know, the flats are clips. I don't know how that's going to pertain to Dave. I'll switch it up right now.
Okay.
What's your favorite rock band of all time?
There you go.
You know, I loved Motley Crue and Quiet Riot growing up.
Yeah.
3 for 3, Dave.
Yeah, it's... Bang Your Head, you know. Then as I got in teenage years, it was Nasty Nursery Rhymes, and you know, when I went through my rap phase,
I take you as a Too Short fan.
Yeah, I was.
Attaboy, attaboy.
Justin can
all
call
right.
that.
Show up.
Well, then you know. Through the Marine Corps, I was stationed at Selfridge National Guard Base. You know, I was the active duty staff on the Marine Corps unit that was there. And I got into Kid Rock a little bit. I got into Eminem a little bit. It was kind of cool being there during those periods.
Which for those tuning in, Selfridge is here in Michigan.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just
north of Detroit.
Yeah. Detroit. I was
my son was actually my son's first open heart surgery was in Detroit Children's Hospital.
Huh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That's where he had his first open heart surgery.
Good hospital. What talent do you have that most people don't know you have? Sort of like your hidden talent.
I was an okay motocrosser.
All right.
Motocrosser. I rode GNCC races with Jeff Redette. You know, we've talked about it in the previous podcast. Mm-hmm. You know, the motorcycle industry goes deep into my family. You know, my dad was a flat tracker, my uncle, and then they were enduro riders. My brother rode Loretta Lynn's in 1982, the very first year of Loretta Lynn's. So that's where my passion is. And it's coming out more and more into the BMX world. I have a lot of plans and a lot of visions on different things that the motocrossers do that I want to bring over to the BMX world. And I think would be really a changer in a lot of things.
I'm all for a mechanic. I don't work on my bike.
You know, it is funny because I'm fairly new into the BMX world compared to most people sitting in the position I am. You know, I started BMX, this industry, in 2014. You know, and I went on the fast track and I jumped in both feet, and you know, I learned a lot, and I have a lot of plans and a lot of visions on things. And Yuri Holick has taught me a great deal. I know there's people that out there don't care for him, but there's people out there that don't care for me and either. And
that, I don't believe that. I don't believe that at all.
Yeah.
Nope.
There is. And I know there is. And that's okay, because I can't please everyone as much as I try. You know, it's a tough industry. It's very small, and there's a lot of us out there. You know, I will not ever talk bad about anyone, because everyone has their good things.
I only talk bad about Chris.
Yeah.
You got the last question?
All right, Dave, this is the most important one. What is your favorite Wednesday night live streaming BMX show?
All things BMX.
Okay. There you go. I thought he was going to say Dirty Knobs for a second.
Did I mess that one up?
No,
you nailed it. Yeah. All right.
Thank you so much, Dave.
Thank you, Dave.
No, thank you.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
We've finished the lightning round. That was the
final round.
That's right.
That's new.
We're going to slide into our newsmaker segment here. And I want to thank our friends from the BMX Racing Forum for bringing us the newsmaker segment each and every week here. So thank you, guys. We appreciate it. And we're going to start it off here. And we'll switch that back there. And Chris, if you want to kick us off here. Oh, that's me. Sorry.
I can.
No, you take that one if you want.
Guys, you got to check this out. If you're in the Lansing area, or you know, you're willing to travel a little bit, you got to get over to Capital City Family BMX on Monday night, because my buddy Justin right here, he's out there doing a Cool Kids Skills Club. All right, so we're starting, it's Monday nights. It starts at 6:30, runs till about 8 o'clock. And there is no cost to this.
And the reason there's no cost is because of awesome sponsors like Bombshell here, and for jumping in with us, because they've donated goods to the kids that this is, you know, tailored for the new kids, right?
Yeah.
And so there's been jerseys and pants that have gone to these kids that Dave sent over, water bottles and all sorts of stuff. And then Gate 9 number plates and Randall David from Backroads BMX, they donated money for all the tour forms. And the tour form is what the tracks typically pay to run a clinic in or a practice. So they took care of all that for us, and 110% nutrition jumped on. And obviously, big shout out to Capital City Family BMX for letting me convince them to try this. But again, it's absolutely free.
Yep.
No cost at all for the riders. You just show up, and if you don't have a license, we utilize the one day or we get you signed up, one or the other there. And it's been pretty awesome so far. We've had a good time.
This is for your novice intermediate rider.
Hey, I heard you have some special guest coaches that may come out.
Yeah. We got Alita and company that was going to join us, but it got rained out. So we're going to have them back here in the next couple Mondays.
So you got Lansing's own Alita Beeman.
Yeah.
Coming out there, helping out. That's cool stuff, man.
All right. And this is going down this weekend, right? Yes.
Yes, this weekend, Saturday, August 20th and 21st at Akron BMX. They're going to have a vintage BMX show in old school swap meet. So it's a two race weekend. Saturday is for everyone, from brand new riders and old school BMXers. There's going to be a race for life. Just so you know, you do not need a USA BMX membership to race the Race for Life. It's one of, but that one and the Bob Warnicke, I believe, are the only two races you can do without a membership. They're going to have a hole shot, 30-year-old and over flat pedal open. where everybody races the main. So that will be extremely interesting. And then Sunday is their state race qualifier. Again, this is at Akron BMX this coming weekend. Guys, get out there and check it out. It's a fun track to ride.
Chris made his main event at the National there.
But I just like that track. I wish it was closer. I would go back there and ride again. It was a lot of fun.
Well, let's go Sunday.
Dude, yeah, let's go.
It's like 3.5 hours.
That's
from
just
here.
Like going to Ray. Stop complaining. Right. You got a new Jeep. Well, I'll hang out the top. You and Damon sit in the front.
Yeah. You got to put some miles on that thing, man.
It's gonna be good. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I've.
You don't go. You're getting a gold tooth. Damon, you want to let him know about the. DB Sports World Raffle?
DB Sports World. All right, sorry.
DB Sports World, the best in the world.
DB Sports World.
All right, check it out. DB Sports World is having a raffle. Also raffling Elite Bike Company, DeSoto BMX. Was that DeSoto?
Destro.
Destro. All right, sorry. Destro Bikes and all proceeds would go to CNY?
Central New York.
Oh, Central New York BMX track. Okay. Here's the cool thing about this raffle. You have a 1 in 20 chance of winning. All right. Yeah. There's only 20 slots. Price is $40 for the raffle. There's only, like I said, you got a 1 in 20 chance. Well, probably got less than that now, but, you know.
You do.
Yeah. A couple of people have been buying up some slots, you know, stuff like that. Yeah. But anyway, the bike will be shipped anywhere in the U.S. There's some left.
There's a few left.
There's a few left. Okay. All right. Anyway, the bike will be shipped anywhere in the U.S., so please check it out. And let's see, the raffle will be drawn on August 28th at the New York State Qualifier on Sunday.
Okay. Very cool.
All right, hit them up on PayPal. We'll post a link in the chat.
Perfect.
As I did. It is there.
Right on it. All right. Here it is. We talked about it at the beginning of the show.
Yeah.
So we're going to make sure we talk about it again.
You got the best voice in podcast doing this one.
There you go.
Yes.
All right, guys, Bombshell BMX, BOGO, for a limited time only, you purchase an Orca and you will receive a 16-inch or a 20-inch park bike for free. And you heard it here first, must go to the same address, just to reiterate. But yeah, that's quite a deal. Go get that fully assembled, complete Orca right easily off of their website and you get a free park bike.
And it has ground shipping included.
Yes.
Yes.
And for that one there, there's a separate place on the website that you click onto it and it's off the top of my head, I think it's $39.99 or $39.49.
Yep.
Shipped anywhere in the United States.
Yep. All right. And I got a late entry here. I'm going to throw up real quick. All right. So this just came in. Hot off the presses, Florida State Championship announced.
Ooh.
What's going down?
I saw that earlier today, man.
You going to go to this championship this year, Chris?
I would love to.
Well, you're going to Akron Sunday. You might as well go.
Yep.
Check it out.
I was actually looking at it. I'm like, they got one in Sarasota. And I go through. I'm like, they don't have one in Sarasota. I got to see where else I can go.
Yeah.
I'd like to go to one just to experience
it. Go to the finals.
Hey, let's all go to March 24th to the 26th of the Charlotte BMX.
Where the bomb squad is.
I got a shirt I can
wear. Melissa can wear the shirt.
Spring break.
The bomb moms.
The bomb moms.
I like Charlotte's track, too.
It's awesome. But check.
Over and under thing.
Man, yep. Check
it. The bridge and stuff. Yeah,
they got like Daytona, Cape Coral, Okeechobee, Oldsmar, Miami South, Charlotte. High Springs, and then the final will be in Orlando. And from the rumors I heard at the final this year when I was down there, the awards ceremony, they outgrew where they were before. So
really?
They got to go. Dude, it was packed. I think it was about 3,000 deep. And I think Nick's in the chat. He can correct me. But I want to say that where they were at with the awards, that was about 3,000 people.
Man,
and
that
it
place
was packed.
Big, dude.
It's huge. And they outgrew it. So I believe they're going to a new arena. And it'll be – it's going to be something, man. So
that would be cool to see.
Yeah, that's exactly. All right. It's that time. It is time – from Alyssa's trivia question, brought to you by Bombshell Racing System. Lots of bombshell tonight.
Dropping the bombshell.
Well, that's just going to be another drop later. I'm going to go back and I'm going to chop that
that's
one out.
Okay,
and it's just going to be a button on the sound deck here.
Dropped
in the bombshell.
I can't. I just can't. It's been a long day. All right. We're
sometimes
gonna...
you just got to be quiet.
No. It's way more fun if you're not. Awesome. I can't even get that light just right. Got a huge sticker pack. It's growing by the week. Tons and tons of good stuff in there. You get your very own hot off the press bombshell catalog, actually. I know, right?
Check that out.
Paper catalog?
We need to check that out before we send that one out.
Whoa.
I got extras.
You haven't all seen those in a while.
Those go in all the goodie bags for the Cool Kids Club.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, cool. Getting them
kids buying stuff right away.
Since Dave was on, I grabbed as much bombshell stuff as I could grab. All right. Anyways, Heavy Pedal Zine here, number 7. This is our very last one.
You guys haven't checked out this Heavy Pedals. You got to do that. It's a cool magazine.
Oh, it is
zine.
Cool.
I'm sorry. Yeah. It is sweet.
I got an answer.
You're fine.
I guess it goes this way.
Well, the plate's upside down.
Oh, yeah, it is.
It's in the package upside down, yeah.
Well, y'all, you know what I'm doing. Anyways. All right. I also got a bombshell t-shirt, adult medium here. And it's all getting wrapped up in your T-bone backpack here, or shoe bag, as we like to use them. All right, let me get back to my question here. So, if my count is right, Dave has joined us on the ATB show a few times over the last couple of years. 4, including tonight, if I think.
Oh, it's more than that.
Well, 4 official.
I was going to say, we did a lot of Vegas.
Yeah. Well, true. These are official, like, podcasts uploaded. One of them was with Alita. Then there was another one in 2021. And then the last show was April. And then today. I want to know, for my trivia question, the date of the 2021 show.
I know that one.
Ooh.
At least the month.
No, we gotta pinpoint this bad
date,
boy.
You think?
Hey, yeah, you gotta pinpoint that.
As soon as I see the date,
I remembered the show now.
Yeah.
Because I knew the last one, but this one, I was like, wait, we did? Okay, all right.
That's a lot of stuff in that prize pack. They gotta get it right.
All right, you heard it here.
Yeah.
It's the support of my crew here. They say full date, but it is in 2021. I'll give you that.
Alita's.
We'll
come back. We'll come back. We will come back.
I will let you try to guess yourself.
Yeah.
First,
yeah.
However.
Yeah. After we get a winner, right?
All right. Chris, you want to let them know who's coming on next week?
Check this out, guys. Next week, August 24th. Yeah. We're going to have Andre LaCroix be hanging out with us. So we'll be talking some pro BMX racing next Wednesday night.
Mm-hmm.
Right here on the All Things BMX show.
Man, kids killing it down there. It's doing big things. All right, we're going to go into our showcase here. And this is brought to you by our good friends at Answer. I want to thank them for sponsoring us and bringing you guys the showcase segment. And we're going to start it off. I got the wrong one lit up, Chris. There you go.
I'm sorry.
There you are.
There. Okay, you're scaring me there for a second. All right, guys, got to check this out. Dirty Knobs Podcast with our buddy Mr. Hollywood Mike Miranda, Eric Carter, and James Vicente. They are talking old school BMX stories from back in the day. They've had, Perry Kramer's been on there, John Cruz, just to name a few. Tommy Brackens has been on there. They have some awesome guests, and they just released this week Mr. Crew Jones, Mr. Bill Allen himself, talking about the movie Rad, his career, how we got started doing acting and all that kind of fun stuff. So go check out the Dirty Knobs Podcast. You know,
no,
these guys have a whiskey company as a sponsor of their podcast now.
They do?
They do. I think it's called, and I'm probably wrong, Michael, let me know if it's, I think it's called Wild Woods Whiskey.
Jack Daniel sponsors this show as much as I spend on them.
That's different,
no,
though.
I feel like you're spending.
But, oh, wait.
You're supporting Jack.
I sponsor them?
Yeah. Yeah, you sponsor
them.
Sponsor
it's a them. Unique partnership.
But
you,
it,
you and
anyways,
Lynchburg go way back.
check out the Dirty Knobs podcast. These guys, it's a lot of fun. Especially you old school guys, you'll like it.
I do have a barrel. I have
a barrel?
Yeah, I mean, I don't own the whole thing, but.
You got
I have a keychain somewhere that says I can go there and drink out of a barrel.
Oh, you got one of them deals. I've heard of that.
I don't really know. It's probably one of those things,
a
pyramid
high
scam.
Roller, son.
I don't know about that, but. All right, Melissa.
All right. Now, as I mentioned earlier in the show, the ladies over at the Moms Talk BMX podcast put out a recent episode. And they titled it BMX and the Military, and they're talking to Seth Spang, who happens to be a new listener tonight. We appreciate that. He is the team owner of a team called the Legion of Valor Racing, and the ladies are talking to him about his mission of helping veterans with BMX. So go take a listen.
Hey, tell him to get in contact with me.
All right. You just did.
We will.
There you go, Seth.
Reach out with us.
Dave.
We'll have you come on the one of the segments here and talk about your team.
Absolutely.
Matt.
Absolutely. And I mean, I try to support as many of those teams as I can. You know, obviously everyone knows I support the Liberty team.
Yeah, we're familiar with them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got a few of those guys up here in Michigan.
Obviously, you guys are. You know, you can see in my background, the Marine Corps, I did 20 years in the Marine Corps and drill instructor and whatnot and quite a bit. So military is near and dear to my heart.
Yeah, he's over on YouTube. So listening, he said he's going to do that and he's much appreciated.
Awesome. I'll get the email address in the chat.
Yep. You're going to connect the dots there.
Yep.
Cool.
All right. Beer Budget BMX show. It's the only live stream open forum show. Discussing hot topics, reply all emails, news, teams, tracks, riders, and more. Did you watch it this weekend?
No, I did not.
They got a new set. They got a new set, man.
It is amazing.
I'm just gonna leave it at that.
Are they still in the garage?
They moved a while ago. They're in Homie Mike's extra room.
But even that, you wouldn't notice.
No, it's I don't know where they got that big-ass Budweiser light for that. That thing is sweet.
Did they step
up like
their game?
Yeah. I think Rick went out and ripped the damn thing off of a front of a bar or something.
I was
going to
say, his local bar is missing the overhang.
Exactly. I got to tell you, though.
I know where it is.
If you haven't watched Beer Budget, this thing is coming in with more heat than a first-time top 10 district mom looking for a factory sponsorship, ladies and gentlemen. It's hot. It's sweaty.
I don't write that, people. That's on him. I write the rest of the script. I have nothing to do with that
classic.
Part.
I throw these out like in 15 seconds, just for the record.
Oh my God.
Hey, well, we're going to put the link in the chat. Oh, Rick said it's from a 49ers stadium. I don't know if he's serious or not. All right.
He probably is.
All right, we're going to round it up here. Damon, you want to let him know about Lane 8 Podcast?
All right, make sure you check out Lane 8 Podcast. This week's episode, Sean Wade. Hard work is the norm. Make sure you check out Lane 8 Podcast hosted by Todd Wilson. Link is in the chat.
Oh, man, it is.
All right. So, hey, if you're a podcaster, live streamer, anything, magazine, like our Heavy Pedals guys here, get a hold of us. We'd love to promote your show, your product, and email us at info@allthingsbmxshow.com, and we will... like I said, we'll help promote your show.
Yeah.
He said it's so musty.
It's so...
What?
Musty. Did, Dave, what was your...
What's your guess on that show there, Dave?
Oh, you're going to put me on live?
Yeah. That's all right if you don't remember. We're not offended. I even know what episode it was, but that's because I could go research.
I think it was December 29th.
It was. Good killer. Yes, it was. And actually,
I think it was the last show of 2021.
It was.
Okay, that's
why. And Alita's was also that month, a week.
It was.
Or two
hers
before.
Was December 19th or something.
I think it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was, or was it right before her birthday?
Yeah. Because I know we had her on, and then Christmas, and then you were right after that.
Yeah.
Because I was. Because
I think
here.
Hers was. Because her birthday is the 11th of December. I'm the 15th of December. Melissa, you're the 20th.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you for remembering that. Wow. I appreciate that.
I better write that down.
Yes, you should.
Justin don't even remember that.
If anybody's surprised, go ahead and give me a few stars, some pity stars on Facebook.
Hey,
I'll take those pennies.
I'm going to stick up for Justin. He will remember when he's sleeping on the couch that week.
So do we have a winner of the trivia?
Yes, yes, we do. We do, actually. Martin Aguilar got it correct.
Hey.
We were over at his house. That's the birthday party that we're at. His daughter's birthday was Saturday. Well, her party was Saturday. That's where we were. So it's out here in California. So you got to ship that.
Oh, that's all right. We'll do. So, yeah, Martin, no message me or the ATB show your address, and we'll get this out to you. And I appreciate you being fast on the Google.
If you want, just send it to me, and I'll give it to him. I mean, he's local to me.
Okay. Oh, yeah, we can do that, too.
Perfect. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the segment you've all been waiting for.
Oh,
are you loosening up over there, Chris?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, it's going down tonight.
I know this is going to be ugly.
You know what? Not really. It's a. Yeah.
Okay.
It's pretty. This week's pretty. Pretty easy on the names.
Tame.
Well,
it's tame.
Until I mess up Dave's daughter's name, then that'll be.
Well, you got all the rest of those to
Hey, I've said
up
it
on
a few times. Hopefully, yeah, you don't mess it up.
That's right.
All right. So, birthdays are brought to you by On Two Wheels. So, you're at the next national and you need some parts, go talk to Jeremy and the folks at On Two Wheels. They will take care of you. So, you're celebrating your birthday this week, Mr. Todd Henry, Justin Rincon, Chris White. Hey, our buddy over at Die Job Apparel, Mr. Sean Gifford, celebrating his birthday. Steve Polk, Kenneth Belcher, Bob Lewis, Answer BMX's Michelle Sanger. How was that?
Perfect. Still in shock. I interviewed her and still can't say her last name right.
Richard Paye, I believe. Paye? P-A-Y-E?
I guess, probably.
Our buddy over at USA BMX, Mr. Justin Wall. Or Wally, as folks know him. Oh, boy. Here we go. Regis Gaudreault.
I don't know.
Okay. I wait
if
for
that's
you
on
guys
a
mo-
if that's on
me
a moto sheet, it's just first name getting announced.
It's Regis.
And Regis
around
is running second. Yep.
And Regis, not Reggie. So.
Yeah.
No, I wait for you guys to kind of like give me, that's right, that's wrong.
So, you know when it's silent, no one knows.
Okay. Chad Miller, Blair Palmer, Jack Eastman, Lewis, Check. Yeah.
We should know he's like a Midwest guy too, but I don't. It's got something to do with TNT. That's what I know.
Chekeki? I don't know. All right.
Shocky?
Camara?
Camaray.
See, I already screwed.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
I'm just going to stop you right there.
I told
Cam
you.
Ray.
Cam Mather. How's that?
Cam Ray.
Ray.
I think Cam probably is acceptable.
Oh, man.
That's awesome.
I even had Dave say it earlier.
I know. And I paid times attention to that, and I'm like, you're not going to mess this one up. And of course,
that's adorable.
I do. All right, we got one more birthday.
You do?
One more.
Yeah.
What do we got?
Maya turns 20 on Monday.
Hey,
your daughter.
Yes,
my daughter. My daughter.
Holy nice cow!
Well, happy birthday!
And what were you just sharing with me on Sunday? What happened in Midland on that very day on that Sunday? Wasn't that?
Oh yeah. Okay, on Midland when we lived this past Sunday, it came across my Facebook 10 years ago. This past Sunday was Maya's first race.
And now really? She's 20.
Now she's 20.
Very.
That's insane.
Wow. Yep. You got a late entry on the birthday. Yeah. You want that one, Alyssa?
Oh, well, Madison Aguilera is turning 14. Yeah. Turned 14. So that must have just happened. And happy birthday, Madison. We hope you had a great day.
Yes. Happy
and you,
birthday.
You got some cool stuff headed your way. I'm going to send it to Dave, and then he can get it to you guys, and you can disperse it amongst the family.
There you go.
All right.
Some pretty so killer stickers in there.
If you want me to butcher your name and the birthday, send it to info@allthingsbmxshow.com.
Because I get the names right now off of Facebook if you're friends with me. And, you know, not everyone likes me, so I'm not friends with everybody. So if you want your name slaughtered by Chris, info@allthingsbmxshow.com.
Rick Carter says, you just effed up your bombshell sponsorship.
So much for that blue and gold shit you were going to get.
Hey, I just sent you a picture of my son and my daughter at her wedding.
I have that, actually. If you give me a second, I actually I had that. I didn't know if you wanted me to throw that one up, but I will.
Throw it up there?
Yeah.
No. I'm sorry.
No, you're good. You're good. You're good. I mean,
they're
so cute. Oh my gosh.
Here we go.
Are they out on?
Nope. I got to drop it here, and then I got to go full screen.
Here to there to.
Here.
There we go.
Yep. That's my son and my daughter.
So great. Cute.
This was in Hawaii, right?
Yep. That was in Hawaii.
Nice. Very nice.
What kind of gym shoes he has on?
Look like some white Nikes.
Yeah. They do look like
crispy,
Nikes.
Too.
Chris. He's got some white Nikes on.
Nice and crispy.
Oh, he just cracked them boys out the box.
Yeah, they look like Damon worn shoes. As in never worn.
Exactly. That's how you do it.
You always keep a pair of shoes like that, though. Like, I got a pair of Vans up in the closet. Ain't worn them yet, but time will come.
I do, too.
Time.
You do?
Yeah, it was one of the buy one, get ones.
Oh.
Yeah, I got it.
What do you do with the other 18 pairs that you have?
Throw them and teach your kid how Vans always land on their soles.
That is true. Yeah. And because of that, her second pair of new school shoes were high top Vans.
Yeah.
So, for now.
But she's breaking in for the first time tomorrow.
There you go.
Tell Damon gets a hold of her and she gets some Adidas.
Oh, we're going to get some Adidas.
Yeah,
we
just haven't made it. I know. You guys can talk about that.
And in 2024, it'll be the Bombshell System Racing. Bombshell Racing System shoes.
Yeah. Exactly.
There you go. There you go.
They'll be co-branded.
After those.
Or designed.
Stasic Striders. Non-Stasic Striders, I should say.
Hey, Dave, we're going to slide on out of here, but I want to turn it over to you before we get out of here for any shout-outs and thanks. I'm going to hand it over to you.
Yeah, I appreciate it. You know, I want to thank all the customers. I want to thank everyone in this industry. You know, it's a big family. I've tried to support as many people as I can through this industry. I love all the competition, you know, from all the companies. You know, we got to work together to grow this industry. You know, big shout out to my daughter, my son, my daughter's birthday, my son for everything he does for us. You guys for, you know, standing behind what we do. And, you know, I know there's going to be people out there that I forget, but I just want to thank everyone for standing behind me and continue to support what we do.
Love it.
Awesome.
And
nice.
We want to say thank you, too, for all the support you give us.
Oh, 100%.
Yes,
for sure.
It's a family, and we got to work together to grow this industry.
Absolutely. Yep.
Absolutely.
For sure.
And you want to give that shout out you wanted to?
Okay. So we got, all right. So yeah, thank you, Dave. We really appreciate it. You guys go check out Bombshell. We got one other person we want to mention here before we get out of here tonight. Mr. Connor Fields has retired from professional BMX racing.
Huh?
Yeah, you didn't know that.
Oh, you
yet?
Haven't seen that video? That's an amazing video.
Yeah, we shared that video on our page. So if you haven't seen
who Connor Fields retired,
yeah,
I wouldn't have known that.
It's only been everywhere for the last few days.
And now he's putting out thank you videos. Yes. Which
are
kind
is
of
he? Cool. Oh, that's yeah. Nice.
Now, if you haven't seen the video, it's really cool. Go check it out. And you know, it's titled "Thank You BMX." Well, we're going to say thank you, Mr. Connor Fields. You know, you've been a great ambassador to our sport, you know, Olympic gold medalist and on and on and on and on. And maybe we'll get him on the show someday.
He's retired. He's going to have time.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Yeah.
Possibility.
But he did say he's retired from professional racing, not BMX riding.
So he's going to race Stasics.
I don't know.
You heard it here first. Completely made up.
Is that a prediction?
I thought he was going for the adult Strider.
It's your ice cold lock. Not a stone cold. It's ice cold, baby. He's racing Stasics.
But, hey, you know, Connor, congratulations, man.
That's a hell of a career.
Thank heck you. Of a career. Yeah. Good dude. And, we hope to still see you around the BMX track now and then.
Yep.
For sure. So, with that, join us next week. Andre LaCroix, be our guest. Everybody, check us out on all the social media platforms at All Things BMX Show. And we will see you next week. God bless everybody. Take care.
Good night.